With the eruption of war in 1914 and the beginning of the collapse of the Austro-Hungarian Empire in 1918, Tomas Bata began reconstruction of his work in the newly formed state of Czechoslovakia. In a war-weary world, the company faced serious new problems: a shortage of raw materials, irregular production, and employment and payroll difficulties. 1922. Post-war economic depression hits Europe. Agricultural produce prices drop. The less fortunate people had little money to spend, and shoe sales drop drastically. Tomas Bata reduced his shoe prices by 50% on the retail market. His advertising campaign was a big success. 1923. An age of reorganization begins, and the introduction of the conveyor is seen. 1923 also saw the introduction of a plan for profit sharing related to incentive, quality production, and effort. This plan, said Tomas, will help to elevate the employees both materially and morally. An employee should understand our business, be part of it, and grow with it. A good beginning to employee-employer relationships. Many young people began to take responsible positions and obtain higher incomes, depending on their ability and performance. Only a few years had passed before the Bata Enterprise, because of its growth, quality products, and affordable prices, became a leader. Up-to-date stores and distribution facilities attracted people, and the challenge developed a code of good loyalty. The industry grew tremendously under the leadership of Tomas Bata. Tomas spent little time away from his demanding responsibilities. Perhaps on a rare occasion, he would pause for a family outing. On a special occasion in the year 1931, Tomas Bata made this long-remembered speech. Let us not be afraid of the future. Half of the people in the world are barefoot, and only 5% of mankind is properly shod. We see how little we have done so far, and how great a task is waiting for the shoemakers of the world. During his travels, Tomas saw calloused feet and injured feet from lack of care and protection, and saw, in many cases, the disastrous effect of hookworm foot disease. He was determined to produce the best quality shoes and create the largest shoe industry in Europe. Around the industry, he built schools, hospitals, homes, printing and publishing houses, and chemical operations. Shops and factories were opened in many countries of the world. And with this expansion, Tomas found it more and more necessary to travel. In search of new markets, he visited India twice. And in 1931-32, he flew to many areas of North Africa, the Middle East, and the Far East. Then on a fateful day in July 1932, Tomas Bata and his pilot took to the air. Minutes later, the aircraft crashed and Tomas and his pilot died in the wreckage. The unbelievable shock of the event hit Zlin and the whole country. This seemingly unending source of energy and ambition had in fact come to an end. The silence of thousands of sorrow-filled employees standing en masse amid a complex of quiet factories was a tribute in itself. Millions of people in all walks of life followed with quiet respect the broadcasting of the burial service. Thousands attended in a mood of great sorrow. One radio broadcaster expressed the sentiments of his nation this way. Today, he said, this nation buried its hero. Every nation at certain times has its hero. He may be a king, a military leader, an actor, or a sportsman. This one was a shoemaker. Although Tomas was no more, the leadership qualities, the spirit of enterprise, his teachings and philosophies lived on. The young people whose colleges he founded carried on with pride and diligence. To customers, Tomas Bata was the champion of service, good products, good prices, and fair dealings. To his employees, he was the founder of worthwhile employment, good income, and to the world, an outstanding example of achievement. His fellow citizens hailed him as a man building a better community for the future of his fellow man. Tomas Bata's business philosophies were his legacy. These and the caliber of men he gathered about him and had left in Zlin at his death. Time is the tester of the value of man, his ideas, and his work. The years between 1932 and 1938 proved the true value of Tomas Bata. These were the years of rapid expansion. Bata Manufacturing appeared abroad in Britain, France, Germany, and Poland. Diversification was taking place through acquisition and construction. Restricted exports, quota systems in other countries, and trade barriers made the need to establish throughout the world even more necessary. Bata Nagar was established in India in 1931. This was one of the first overseas factories. By the time the mid-30s had arrived, plans for expansion were well laid in North Africa, the Middle East, and Singapore. By the end of the 30s, the organization was in five European countries, Africa, and the Far East. 1939, expansion to North America, and a new era, to new markets, new horizons.